Hello and welcome to the second episode of Motion in Monogram. In this episode we will be covering what numerical analysis is, how we can use it, why we use it, and why we specifically use Verlet integration instead of something like Runge-Kutta integration. I will also include a little bonus part showing why we use fixed time set instead of tauta time. What is numerical analysis? It is the use of algorithms to approximate solutions to mathematical problems. Specifically, we as game developers use it to usually solve acceleration problems. It allows us freedom to customize acceleration however we'd like. For example, if we had a little spaceship traveling between two planets, we can just add the forces of both planets to the spaceship and solve it from there using a very small algorithm. Now let's express this mathematically. Suppose we have a system with the following variables. Acceleration is 2 meters per second squared. Displacement is 0 and velocity is 0. Now this is very easy to solve, we can just use Newton's equations, given we have time. However, this is a problem, as acceleration is constant. And because it is constant, we lack freedom. Many times there will be objects that have multiple sources of acceleration, and we need to calculate the new acceleration every time at that exact interval when using Newton's equations. Therefore, we need an easier way. We can also say acceleration is a function, but again, how will we solve this? Will we use the derivative of acceleration, jerk, or will we use that derivative? And so on. Somewhere it will need to be constant. However, if we use numerical methods, we can approximate solutions, therefore having non-constant acceleration. Acceleration is that of functions, and we can solve almost any acceleration problem. Let's look at a more hands-on example, a traveling spaceship between two planets. Each planet exerts a force on the spaceship, therefore the spaceship has non-constant acceleration. And the spaceship's acceleration depends on where it is in space. Traditionally, we would need to calculate the acceleration for every position of the spaceship and go from there. However, if we use Verlet integration, we can just add forces for the planets themselves. Now we assume the spaceships and the planets' mass are 1, just to make this easier. But if you take a look at the source code for this little demonstration, you see it's much simpler. Here is the code for the project. As you can see, we get the acceleration from the two planets, and we add it directly into our next position using Verlet integration. Much easier than actually calculating everything manually. I would just like to mention a few integration techniques that are common in the world of game development. These are the Verlet integration technique, the Runge-Kutta method, and the Euler methods. There's the explicit and semi-implicit Euler methods. The explicit one isn't great, so go research the semi-implicit one. You'll see it's pretty good for simulating celestial bodies. We're going to use the Verlet integration method because we can directly change position and create cloth and rope and stuff like that, and can be a bit more easier to implement. The last topic I want to deal with in this video is the issue of fixed timestep. So with variable timesteps, that is, you calculate how much time has passed between the two renders of your game, and you multiply your physics by that amount, you can end up with inconsistent physics. And you hope that your delta time matches your refresh rate. For example, you hope that the time between the previous frame and the current frame is at like 60 Hz or 75 Hz. If it's not, you're going to get a weird image and you might get many artifacts from that perspective. Moreover, if you have a slow or fast PC, the game will run inconsistently and you can't be sure that you will have the same behavior every time you run your game. So how can one implement this fixed time step? Well, one approach is calculating the total frame time. That is, let's say you have 75 Hz monitor, but your physics is going only at 30 Hz. Then you consume 30 Hz and then the 60 Hz. Then you have a little bit left over. Now, for that leftover piece, you will interpolate between the previous frames. So you won't jump from 10 to 100 pixels when your character is moving. This won't have exact pixel precision that you might need in the FPS shooter. However, it will ensure that your physics is consistent and you can run it on almost any computer. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any questions, go ahead and ask in the comments and I'll get back to you. Have a lovely day.